Boa tarde, tudo bem?
Fala, Chuck.
Tudo bom?
Tudo bom.
Vamos começar. Hello to everyone. Felipe. I will ask you to admit people, okay?
Yes, I'm looking after that.
Thanks. So we are doing this call in English, okay, as we have teams from other countries. And let me explain what's going on here, right? Because I believe that there are people here that know more about the project, that is participating more, and also some new invitees for the race. So today is the day that we are launching our competition. We did have a competition in the past, but was the first competition. We were starting to build our own races. So it was something very small and closed, let's say. And right now we have the opportunity to open this AI competition or this autonomous vehicles race to different universities and companies around the globe. Not only universities and companies, also individuals with teams can also race and participate. And we are going to talk a little bit about the rules, okay? It's a pleasure to be here. I'm going to share my screen and go through a quick presentation, okay, guys? It's like 18 slides, but also we are going to have walk through the simulation with Guilherme from our team. So what we are going to talk today is about the AI competition for autonomous vehicles, then our racing track pretty quickly, because as we are going to have a demonstration, so let's pretty quickly talk about it. Talk about the ego vehicle, the algorithms that we have inside our simulation and our vehicle today, and where can we go, right? What can we do? The competition agenda and rules. So we are having some news here about the competition. We are doing three races this year, so we are going to present moreover. We are not talking about sponsorship here, sorry, it's out of the contents here. Then about Skoods and quickly about our context, okay? So I would like to ask you to please note your questions. You can also send your question in the chat. Felipe Madeira from our team will be curating all the questions. And after doing this first presentation or the first walk through all the slides in the simulation, we will respond to questions. We will open for you guys to also open your camera. Okay, it's an open conversation, not a monologue, okay? So, what is the AI competition for autonomous vehicles, right? These are races, and the objective here is to collaborate, learn, develop, and compete. So teams have to code their own algorithms for autonomous vehicles to win the races, okay? So each team will have one car competing. We are having three races. Now it's 2020, one in October, November, December, in the middle of the month. Skoods will provide the 3D simulation environment of different tracks for different challenges. So I guess most of you already saw our new simulation that we are going to show today again. But we also have other two new simulations for the other two races that we are going to talk more over. An autonomous vehicle will be provided in the simulation connected to an external Python programming environment. So what does that mean? It means that we have the digital twin of a car inside our simulation. We have a port of communication between our simulation and outside environments. In the case of 2020, we are working only with Python. So we can code cars only in Python this year. Probably next year, we are gonna also work with ROS. But this is something to discuss. And finally, we have a starting Python code, which is available for the teams. It's a starting code, very basic, but we're going to talk more about it. Okay, so basically what we have in the beginning of the competition, it's like a game, a video game, right, for cars. We have the simulation, we have the track, we have the car, and now we need the player. And who is the player? The player is the AI done by the teams. And we definitely have a starting point for the teams, okay? So advancing, these are some general pictures of our simulation. I'm gonna jump this slide here as Guilherme is gonna show us the simulation environment. This is the Eagle vehicle, okay? This, we have the digital twin of this very cool and sport car here. We can... We work with sensors, with virtual sensors in this car. For example, the GPS, we have cameras. So we position cameras, we define the resolution and the features of the cameras. We have the LiDAR virtualized. LiDAR is the laser sensor, right? Which creates the 3D, a point, what we call a point cloud around the car. Then we have the IMU, inertial measurement unit, and wheel odometry. So these are all sensors and sources of data for the algorithm. You can see that we are not working with radars yet, okay? So here's one example of the capabilities of our sensors. So for the cameras, we have data of depth and segmentation. So not only the pixels of the images. And why is that? Because when working with simulation, we have the privilege of having this information, the ground truth information. So segmentation and depth, they are two kind of images or coded images that we can use to train more advanced machine learning and deep learning algorithms. So this is one of the capabilities of our system. For example, we can get the segmentation image here and train a deep neural network to classify each of the pixels and objects of the scene, which can later be used in real world applications. And this is another example of the LiDAR. So we virtualize the LiDAR, we can define the number of channels, the frequency of the rotation and different parameters of the LiDAR and actually simulate it in a very realistic way. Here's just one example. These green dots are the bug of our LiDAR. And what to do with all this information, right? So just as an introduction here, especially for the people that don't know the software of self-driving cars. So this is an example of a simple architecture of self-driving cars. Okay, we have the sensors. Let me use the laser pointer here. We have the sensors, then we have the software stack. We work with perception and mapping side by side. So perception is understanding the world around you, and mapping is after you understand the world around you, you have enough data to know where you are in the world, comparing to a map that you have. So after having this, we have planning and control. And planning is to define where do you wanna drive, right? The waypoints that you want to follow, and actually control is actually following the waypoint. So and in the end, we have the actuators, which is the accelerator, throttle, brake, and steering. Okay? There's no gears, no clutch for these races, just throttle, brake, and steering. Okay. Pretty as simple as that for this. It's very simple, but still very, let's say, close to our reality, right? With automatic cars. But actually, this is a general overview of the whole architecture of a self-driving car. But I would like to show you guys this, which is what we have right now in our very simple autonomous vehicle for the races. So this is the starting point for the teams. We can see that there is no mapping and perception here, right? So teams right now don't need to worry about localization, which is localizing with the LiDAR data, and sure you can use cameras as well, but we don't need to worry about this now, especially for this season. We are using data from the simulation for the localization, okay? Sure, for the next year, our team is already working on a template code or a starting code for localization, so teams can get from here. But let's say that the fun part is on planning and control, right? Because that's where we create the magic of the race. Sure, localization is very important. The coherency is very important. But here is where the creativity lives and the emotion of the races lives, okay? So that's what we have today for our very simple car. We have a planning algorithm, which is a waypoint cloner. It clones the waypoints that you can play with the simulation like a video game and record your speed profile and waypoints, and you can mimic it. And in the control, we count with two PID controls, one for steering, one for the throttle and brake, which controls the car. So the good thing is that teams can, let's say maybe in 10 minutes, teams can go to zero to start racing just by running the starting code and just by cloning new waypoints and fine-tuning the PID parameters. So, but just by doing this, teams can start playing, can start racing. And sure, and sky's the limit. We can do anything between this very simple car and a very complex car to have the best and to win the races. Okay? So advancing, so algorithms, integrations, and backlog. So here's also what we are, our backlog. So we do have the sensing API emulation. Okay, we can work with algorithms for static and dynamic objects perception and localization. For localization for the next year, to work with occupancy grid, roadmap, localization mapping. For the planning stack of the software, we have the mission behavior and trajectory planning, longitudinal and lateral control, and actuators control emulation. For object and event detection and response, OEDR, as we call, we can use different techniques here as well as deep learning, sensor fusion, behavior prediction, finite state machine behavior planning for working on our car. So this is not implemented yet. These are just the capabilities of our systems, okay? And the technologies are Python for this year, 2020. And for the next year, we'll work with ROS, C++. And sure, we are capable of integrating with different tools like MATLAB, CarSim, SolidWorks, and others. But it's still undefined if teams can use or not paid toolboxes and so on. And actually, this decision is going to be made with the teams. Okay, we're going to have some weekly meetings with the teams. So this is a decision that we are bringing to the competition as a whole. So now we have a video of the simulation. I think here things start to get more excited, but I would like to ask Guilherme, please Guilherme, if you can walk through the simulation, would be better.
Okay, do you want me to go directly through the simulation or you play the video first?
No, go straight to the simulation, please.
Okay, no problem. Everybody can see my screen?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. Well, here you have a simulation of a racing track. We are using a car, a sport car. And just in front of you, the green dots are the bug of the LiDAR sensor. So you can use this feature if you want to see where the laser beams are going. And we have, I use now Xbox, a very common Xbox joystick to drive the car for a while. So yeah. Here. I have to open again, I'm sorry.
No problem.
Disconnect.
Or you can do it from the keyboard as well if it's not working the joystick.
No, just because it's disconnected.
Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the car
Yeah. Maybe you're gonna have some lag because about the internet, but here in my screen, I can assure you, I can drive smoothly. I am using a GPU, an NVIDIA GPU RTX. So I already talked about a laser, the LiDAR, the bug. Now we have here a depth camera that you can use to infer depth. Here we have a segmentation camera where you can use to make inference about the segmentation of road and trees and sky. And here we have a regular camera. One of the other features that here in this simulation is the weather conditions that we can hear. For example, I put some fog and some leaves. I have to enable here. Cannot forget. I always forget this checkbox, and I start to fight with the simulator, and Fernando remind me, check the checkbox.
Okay, so apply all.
Yeah. Thank you. So here, we have some weather conditions that you can also play with the weather conditions, wind, and it's harder now to drive. One of the way to connect to the simulation, it's using Python. And here I'm going to show you a snippet of our code for
that,
the first steps.
Before that, let's give a ride around the whole
okay.
track in a sunny day, prefer.
Okay.
So the conditions of the race can change dynamically as well, right, guys? So you can make it more fun. because it changes also the friction with the pavement.
Yeah, the car, it's very, the dynamics of the car, the car slips a lot when you put the throttle very it's straight up. Mm-hmm. So you have to take care with this. I'm here, I'm controlling the joystick. And also you have the brakes you have to use carefully, because if you use the brakes too strong, you also can make the car to be unstable. Mm-hmm. And the same for throttle and the same for steering. So
the car is tuned, so it's very sensitive to the controls. So
yeah,
if you are just a little bit better with your software, it can make a lot of difference.
Yeah, so, for sure. Because even having the localization, it has some challenges to make the car drive in high performance, even we are giving the localization.
Definitely, yeah. Okay, since you're out of the track, okay. Thanks, thanks, Guy. Maybe we could show just a quick snip of our code, just to show the technical guys of the meeting.
Are you seeing my screen?
Yep.
Here we have the code. Actually, a snippet, just a starting code that you can see here. We have the Skoods library and garage. It's for the PID car. We have a controller, a PID for throttle and two brakes. And here you can see it's very easy and straightforward to use. It's nothing complex. I don't know if Fernando, do you want me to show how to driving using the PID or not? I have already some waypoints recorded.
Okay, yeah, let's make it drive by its own.
Now the car will drive using the autonomous mode. I'm not sure if it work perfectly. I record some waypoints, but I think I did not record the whole racing track.
No problem. Just as an example.
Yeah, you can explain. Go.
It will ask you if we want to first qualify, right?
But I have already the waypoints and everything done, so I have to race now.
Yeah, it's gonna ask if you want to record data. You can go to the simulation gear. We'll explain while you show. If you want to record data, manual data, if you want to qualify, or if you want to race. And after you choose these options, it's going to ask if you want to run it in real time, or if you want to stop the simulation every time you want to think. Because if your software is too complex, it may, and your machine is not that good, it can take more time for you to think, your software to think, than to respond. So you can keep pausing the simulation just to give you the possibility of developing self-racing cars without a very good machine or computer, okay? So yeah, these are the good things about working with simulation.
Now it's using the autonomous mode.
Yeah, it's in autonomous mode. Okay.
Yeah, it happens.
Yeah. So yeah, it happens when you don't record enough points.
Yeah.
So okay, so this is the general overview of the simulation. I would like, thanks Guy. Let's advance. Let me stole your screen. Guys, let me know when you can see my screen, okay?
Yep.
Okay, so how is going to be the races, right? I told that it's three races. But the races are not equal. They are not equal in the way in the environment. But they do are equal in the platform that we are using, right? Our simulation, our API to communicate and everything. So this is the plan for this year. So we are having three races with very different scenarios for each race. So first in October, we have the Skoods Cup, which is this new racing scenario that we just showed, okay? So we have meetings before the race. We call them Q&A meetings, the qualifying draw and the qualify meetings. They will take place every Wednesday this time, 7 p.m. Brazilian time, GMT minus 3. And we are going to align around the rules of the competition. The teams will bring their needs, demands, and what they need if something is lacking, or their opinion on some key decisions that we need to make until the race. So it's closer to a real car race, right? In which the teams they interact with the organization of the event to bring the best race. So this is how we are going to roll it, okay? So, and actually what happens is that, and for the first race, or for all these races, it's just one car on the track. There is no other agents, okay? So for the second race, we are changing the scenario. And we are going to a scenario of a mining. So there is differences in let's say the way you drive your car, but to code is the same platform, but the car is bigger, the power is different, right? And also the friction with the soil is different. The mission is going to be different. And this will take place in mid-November, also with the same structure. We have the Q&A meeting, we have the qualifying draw, and the qualify. And finally, for December, we have the Moon Race, which is this challenge in a very different scenario. The good thing here is that we can, by changing gravity, by changing friction, and other parameters, it's a very good way to play with the engineering of autonomous vehicles, you know, because the softwares are the algorithms are the same, but sure, the outputs will be different based on the conditions of the environment. So this is the last race of the three. And our idea is to have also these three races for the next year. So in the next year, we will have more races, more environments to play with or to code to. And but these three will repeat again. Okay, so it's like real racing in which you have different circuits. But here we can be more creative and we can trip a little bit when talking about scenarios and the races, okay? The rules of the AI competition, so let's go quickly here. I already spoke about these four items here, which are the meetings. I will send this material to you after the meeting, guys, so you can have the details here. All the meetings and events will take place on Wednesday, like I said, from 7 to 8:30 p.m. Brazilian time. teams from companies, universities, and independents can register with a minimum of 3 members. Teams must participate in the weekly meetings with at least 1 member. Okay. And teams need a Microsoft Windows machine with a GPU or a cloud instance. So our solution also works with instances on the cloud with Windows machines and GPUs associated. We are trying to, you know, we are trying to get instances for the teams without cost, so we can, you know, we can compete under same conditions with the same hardware just by having the same instance for everyone, every team on the cloud. But this is something ongoing. So we must start racing and we will let the teams know when and if we have these instances. Just talk a little bit about Skoods pretty quickly. Okay, and then I'm going to talk about our team as well. So I would like to ask our team to also be prepared to speak a little bit about each of you guys. So Skoods is an autonomous vehicle race team developing competitive AV engineer and simulation. So since 2018, we opened the community and all these people interested around AV racing. In 2018, we have more than 230 people joining the community and downloading the simulation and interacting. And so 3D what we do, right? 3D simulation and digital twins and autonomous vehicles algorithms. We develop autonomous vehicles technology, making the bridge from the races to real applications. And what we our vision, you know, is that race technologies for autonomous vehicles contributes uniquely to everyday applications and will help save millions of lives in the future. From 2018 to 2020 now, we worked on a few projects. This one was a very cool project that we did. It's a POC. We included a Renegade on the land of Mars. Actually, the Renegade is a real digital twin of the Renegade, and the surface of Mars is a real digital twin of the surface of Mars with data from NASA, from lasers and the textures, even the rocks. The rocks are designed as being the Mars rocks. It was an open project from the NASA that did all this 3D design of Mars and open all this data for companies and individuals all around the globe. So it was a pretty cool POC. But we already have some POCs on other cars, on trains, autonomous trains as well. So it's pretty cool to see how developing this kind of technology can lead you to help and work on different projects, right? Which are similar in a way, not equal, but sure, similar in a way. So I would like to present quickly our team, okay? So actually I'm gonna turn off my screen sharing. And I'm gonna call Felipe Madeira as you are here. Felipe Madeira is helping us for some time with relationship with companies and so on. So please, Felipe.
Hi everybody, thanks for watching this special launch of our Skoods challenge. I'm talking lead on relationship for the team. So we're talking to companies, talking to sponsors, talking to the ones interested in making this happen. So my background is in engineering and in the environment of automotive, but I found very interesting that this should go on, and my efforts here along with this brilliant team is to make it happen, even taking care of a business model and the ways that will support a long life for Skoods. Thanks for joining, and any questions, just let us know.
Thanks, Felipe. Yes, guys, please write our questions in the chat if you want. Felipe will read for us after this. Shuki, you're the next here. Shuki is joining late recently the team. He is specialist in car dynamic of vehicles. Shuki, please, a quick introduction.
Yeah, so my name is Luis Shuk. I currently work for Meritor here in Troy, Michigan, United States. My best experience is with Suspensys and Random Group on designing suspensions for commercial vehicles like buses and trucks. And for all this career, about 25 years, I'm involved with vehicle dynamics.
Thanks, Shuk. Let me give the word to Guy. Guilherme, please.
Yeah, my name is Guilherme Bortolazzo, but everybody call me Guy because it's easier for most of the people who are not a Portuguese speaker. I'm engineer. I'm control automation engineer. I'm responsible in Skoods for the simulation and for testing. As well, I'm responsible to integrate the solutions that come from the other teams inside of our stack. So if you have any technical questions or how to implement the simulation or how to start your code, feel free to reach me out. I believe I can respond most of your questions. Thank you.
Thanks, Guy. Let's give the word to Alexandre as well, which is working since the first email for the community. Alexandre.
Hey, good evening, everyone. My name is Alexandre. I am I work as a solution architect, and currently I'm working as a solution architect in Sweden. I work for connected vehicles segment and integrating vehicles and into new and very different environments. So Skoods is a very, very nice initiative, and I'm pretty sure that we will be able to have fun and innovate a lot in here.
Thanks, Alexandre. Thanks also to be here. It's late night where you are, right? The time zones, we have four time zones in our team. And now we are going to the earlier time zone of our team, which is Ren.
Hi, everyone. It's tomorrow already in Australia. So yeah. I'm in Melbourne, in Australia. It's a pleasure to be part of the team. I'm a software engineer by trade. I've been working in artificial intelligence for quite a long time now. And I'm really excited about being part of the team and working with machine learning. So hi, good to meet you all.
Thanks, Ren. I think now we have Nicholas. Right, Nicholas, would you like to introduce yourself a little bit?
Hello, everybody. My name is Nicholas dos Santos Rosa. I'm a graduate in electrical engineering. Right now, I'm a PhD student at the University of São Paulo. And currently, I'm researching virtual computer applications using deep learning techniques for self-driving cars. I'm also one of the responsible for the automation process of your new autonomous car. And here in Skoods, I'm part of the object event detections and localization team. I would like to thank you for your presence, guys.
Thanks, Nicholas. Let me just check if Avelino, Rafael, and or Yasser are here, guys. Yeah, a few of them. Yeah, they told me that they were not be able to come here, but I will make a quick introduction. So Avelino is PhD and researcher at the Federal Institute of Espírito Santo, specialized in AV robotics and also with an MBA in project management. He works with localization. He's working on the car of the next year with Nicholas for the localization algorithms. Rafael is a professor also for the Federal University of Paraíba. He is the coordinator of AV and robotics. He specializes in AV, flight, machine learning, and robotics. It's funny. Each of the teams we meet from somewhere, right? I met Rafael from Paraíba in a picture event. We are taking picture for magazine Veja, and he was for a post called Engineers of the Future. And Rafael, he built a whole robotic a laboratory in the countryside of Paraíba, which is one of the smallest states of Brazil. So he did it in the middle of nowhere, something amazing. So and also Yate,
I'm here.
Hi Rafael.
Hey, so guys,
introduce yourself, please.
Yep, it's really nice being here with you guys, and Skoods is done really nice job, and it's really important what you guys are doing, because our technology here in Brazil needs that. So I think that's it's important promoting this kind of competition here in Brazil, because we need people in this field. So self-driving cars, I really believe that self-driving cars and mobile robots, I really believe that this kind of subject is important for the future society. And it's really fun being part of this team. Okay, guys, I hope we can be together in this competition, and I really would like to see a lot of fun in this competition, a lot of cars running really fast and furious. That's it.
I think you are on mute.
You are in mute, Fernando.
Oh, sorry. From time to time, I do it. At least once a day. And last but not least is Yasser, that couldn't be here as well. He just sent me a message. He's a control engineer. He works with flight control, and he's helping us right now. He's helping us more with the idea of bringing a drone competition as well. Because our simulation is ready for drones. And in our team, we already have 5 people with specialization in flight control. So, which is similar to AV, but not equal, right? That's the team. And after having describing the whole team, and I think I only have one comment, which is we're going to receive all the subscriptions, let's say, or the teams that want to join by email, okay, which is hi@skoods.org. The only requirements are you need at least 3 people in the team. And yeah, the will to make it faster than the other teams. Okay. So let's open for questions. Felipe, if you have any questions, please let us know. Also, guys, please, you can open your camera or your voice and make questions live. We still have 50 minutes, 40 minutes that we can use only for conversations. Okay.
Oh, Damasio, no questions from my side. I just would like to to congrats you and your team to this launch. And we are very proud to see a project like this with quality and with innovation here with all the team that are participating in this project. Congratulations to all of you.
Thanks, Alessandro. Thanks very much. Yeah, it's a pleasure to have you here, SCIE, the Society of Automotive Engineers, here as well. Our good friends.
My pleasure. Supporting
Skoods since the beginning, yeah.
My pleasure. Congratulations again.
Thanks.
We got a first question here, Fernando. Felipe is asking, for the first race, the teams have to be ready and deliver the final code on the 7th of October. That's the qualify. Is that right?
No, the qualify is the you have to bring your code, you know, for the qualify. You have the code for the qualify. We are going to race for the qualify. For the race, you can improve your algorithm for the race. Okay. All you have to do is to resend the code by the time of the race. No problem. The only advantage from the qualify is that if you are the first in the qualify, you take off from the first position of the grid. Okay, you start in the first position. If you're the second in the qualify, you start in the second position of the grid for the race. But only one car on the track at the same time, okay? It's just, you just win a few meters for the qualify. But you can change your code for the final race.
Okay, Fernando. João Zenobio, he has another question. Does the simulation files will be shared here or somewhere in our website? He was testing the older one, and the download page, he couldn't find the download page. He says download page is missing there on the website.
Okay. Well, guys, let me show you our site. We changed it a little bit from 2 days ago. It's very simple right now, okay, guys? We are focusing more on the engineering side and less on the website builder right now. So it's have some new introduction here, but if you click on Get Started Now, it's going to take you to a document with details about the races, okay? And if the first part here, it's in the presentation that I just did now for you guys. Then we have the requirements, and then download and run the virtual track. So this is the link, okay, to download. And here we have some instructions that you can quickly follow and start racing your car. Like, you know, in 10 minutes, you can be racing an AV car, even if you're not a data scientist. Okay, I'm gonna paste here in the... download files. Okay. Did I answer the question?
João, can you just confirm that it was clear now, please? Yeah, João's still thinks the download area is missing or the link is broken, something like that. If you can check.
I just tried as well. The link is broken.
Okay.
Right. Guy, would you please check if the file is open for?
Yeah, I'll check now.
Thanks, Guy. And Rafael is just mentioning if we thought about the prizes or how we're gonna take the congratulations or the hugs, special hugs for the winners.
Yeah, we are definitely having hugs.
That's
about the prizes. We didn't define. We didn't define yet, because first we need to support companies supporting and companies with us, right, to give some resources, some prizes, but not defined yet. Okay, we're gonna announce during the day of the race. It can be hugs, it can be resources, computers, it can be money, who knows.
Yeah, we'll let people know as the competition moves on. Lucas wants to check with us if there is any way or a source of channel for people who are not in a university or belongs to a company to form and to make a team.
Yes, people from university can join teams. People from companies can join teams, and also other individuals. Okay, there is no limits here, Lucas. You can invite. I know you're from Pookie, right, Lucas? If it's the Lucas that I'm thinking. You can join with people from Pookie, you can join from people from companies or your friends from nowhere, okay? No problem at all.
And Guy just sent over the chat a temporary link for everybody until we make it a definitive one on the website. Thanks, Guy.
Okay.
Yeah, Lucas is confirming he just graduated, so he's not linked to the university or to PUC anymore. But yes, Lucas, you can arrange yourself with colleagues and propose a team.
Yeah, we're going to create a channel for people to, if you don't have a team, for example, even if you want to join the race, we're gonna promote this exchange of contacts and so on between people, okay?
And for sure, the code is open. So in the case, everybody's completely free to download and to use the code and run their own algorithms.
How many people each team? We said minimum and maximum. Can you just repeat and rephrase that for everybody? Make it clear, Fernando, please.
Yes, please. The minimum is three people per team. Okay, we don't have a maximum. Guys, sure. These some details of the race and how the teams will engage with each other, we're going to develop together with the teams, but the minimum is three.
And we do require a representative to be on the weekly meetings, right?
Yes, at least one representative for the weekly meetings.
Does the competition will support other operating systems than Windows? I guess that's completing the question from Alison.
Yeah, not for now, Alison. We do know that we have the capabilities to make it work on Linux, also for Mac, but Mac it's not. But for now, we need to focus only on Windows because that's the way that we to have the time to give support. But one thing I can assure you, we can if you only have Linux, for example, you have to make it on Linux. Let's speak with Guy. Let's try to make it work for now, okay? But the official support is for Windows, but Guy is gonna help us, right, Guy?
The magician.
Yeah,
Guy, it's possible.
Yeah. Yeah, it's possible. It's possible to build a version for Linux. It is not a problem. The only thing that we have to evaluate the code, the code, everybody in the same kind of environment. So because we can have some issues when you are running a code in Mac, Linux, and Windows, and for surprisingly you, the test I did, Windows is being more better performance than Linux. Yeah, I'm surprising you, but it's true. But yes, it's not a problem if you want to develop your code in Linux, in Linux environment, but will be evaluated in a Windows machine.
Thanks, Gui. Just to confirm, João is requiring if we have a communication channel. I think we have the website. Do we have any other ways to promote and to give the updates, Fernando, to the teams or to the community in general?
So we are gonna build a WhatsApp group for the leads of the teams. Okay, so we can quickly exchange communications. You can send emails to hi@skoods.org. We also have a forum, support forum in our website. So if you click on discussions in our website or sign in, you can join and also make questions there. We will receive the questions here. So email, WhatsApp for the teams that are joining, and the forum.
Okay, if the email is not clear to everybody, just put on the chat as well. It's just hi, at skoods.org. Okay, João, thank you for asking.
We're also going to share this video, okay, this video recording to all of you after the meeting. Also, a couple of PDFs, the presentation and the competition rules.
Okay, just confirming, Fernando, we are accepting teams worldwide, correct? There is no limit in terms of from where people are.
No limits from where people are, so we are expecting teams from the US, from India, I hope from Europe, okay, probably from England, from the UK, and yeah, we still don't have a limit for the number of teams. Like, do we have a maximum? We don't know yet, because it depends on support that we have and also on the teams, right? So let's see how it goes, but we are not limiting right now, okay?
Thanks, Fernando. I don't see any new questions in the last couple of minutes. Does anybody want, okay, there is a coming one.
Hi, Felipe, I just wanted to say something.
Yes, go ahead, please.
I couldn't help noticing that most of us speaking today were from Brazil, and also the fact that we don't have any woman in our teams. Mm-hmm. So I think we need to find a way to encourage people from diverse backgrounds, from other backgrounds, to be part of the competition. So women, and please, it's an open competition for all over the world, so we need to get work on getting more people from other countries. So it's just a comment. I think
nice.
I'll take my part.
No, you'll be very nice.
Too. Yeah,
completely
Ren.
Agree with you, Ren.
Well reminded. Thanks for the ad. Felipe Ribeiro, Gui, I think that's I'm gonna shoot for you. He's asking if MX 150 GPU will be enough, or he's gonna have some trouble with that. Machine. Gui, you are in mute.
Sorry. I do a benchmark and can keep. You can keep going. I will respond in a few minutes. I just do a benchmark here.
Okay. Thanks. Online support from Gui, the magician.
Felipe, also, yes, just to the Felipe Ribeiro, to explain him. Our first race was very simple. It would run in any notebook, okay? Any, without a GPU and anything. For this new simulation, we did something more a better design, better 3D, right? It's more detailed, so it's bigger and consumes more memory, especially the GPU. But if we don't get the instances for the teams, that's why we are trying the instances, right? To make it even for all. But if we don't get it, we are able to tweak the quality of the graphics and to make it work also, you know, on lower GPUs. But again, this has to be fine-tuned with all the teams, right? We need some effort to do so. So we need to identify if the teams have or not the resources to work on it. So I'm just saying that to say to you, like, let's advance. We don't want to stop on lack of resources. Okay, guys, here it's all about science and competing. Scientists competing. So we are going to solve all the resources issues. Guy?
Sure, we will.
Yes. The GPU EMX 150. One very important thing is, first of all, do not turn on the LiDAR debug. Will not work. Definitely will not work because this feature consume a lot of the power of the GPU, and for also the cameras, maybe you can use directly in the, if you need the images, use directly capturing the images in the code, and do not use the cameras to use. Maybe you can use for just for debugging or just for seeing what are you doing. But definitely you have to be very, how can I say, you cannot spend a lot of resources when you are using a max 150. But yes, it will work, but you have to be conservative using the resources. And maybe you have to check in your computer if you have any another resource using the GPU. So more light your system is, will work.
Thanks, Guy.
Thanks, Guy. And that goes to our friend Takahira as well, who mentioned the same GPU board.
Just one comment on this. We don't often use the debug for lighters, okay, guys? It's just to put some green dots on the scene and make it cool. It doesn't add anything to the knowledge, okay? No big deal.
The same for the cameras I show you. You can capture the images directly from the code without actually seeing the image. So it's another thing that consumes a lot of from the GPU.
Thanks, Guy, again. I don't see further questions, and if anybody wants to open the microphone as well and yeah, mention anything, we are more open to go join the conversation. Please make yourself comfortable.
No rush, guys. We can wait a couple of minutes here. No problem.
I can show an overview of the racing track using the drone, if you want. You can see the racing track from above.
Did you demonstrate that video, the one that you showed us before, the one with the car racing?
Actually, it wasn't a video. I know. You didn't see?
No.
When I showed the okay, I can show again the simulator if somebody arrive later.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I will.
While people are making questions, we can. Much better than see us is to see this beautiful racing track.
And if you can put the sound as well, that would be fantastic.
So Guy is already playing with the drone.
okay, that's
yeah. Awesome. Here you can see an overview. I'm terrible drone pilot. You can see. But here we can see an overview from the racing track.
So guys, this is a cool thing because we can use the same scenarios that we are using for the AVs, for the drone competition that we are working on. So yeah, this is using the same resources, sharing resources. Okay. Let's make the AV, Guy.
Okay. The problem is the lag in the internet.
No problem, Guy. It's just we know it's
slow. I'll go inside the boxes to I didn't went there.
Okay, no, you I remember that there was a video, a promoting video right at the beginning that had that song playing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking.
Me. Okay. Okay, if Fernando want to play the
well, the video has no sound. Would you like me to play, Ren?
Yes, you can enable the sound when you share your screen. So you have to stop sharing your screen and share it again. So you enable the sound right at the moment you share your screen.
So I have to stop sharing?
You stop sharing and you share it again. Then there is that sharing button. At the moment you share that on the left-hand side, there will be share sound. Oh,
sure.
Well, I'm actually using my Mac version, so I don't know.
I'm using Mac as well.
Okay, yeah. So no, I realize that in Mac you cannot share the sound. It's a pity, but that video is brilliant.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's go.
That's why it's good to have.
Yeah, the sound.
I can hear the sound.
Yeah, I listen this. Yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Thank you.
O som foi?
Yes, we could hear. Brilliant. Thank you very much. I think people need to hear that, to see that presentation. So, thanks.
Nice.
Yeah, it was a great remark, Ren.
Thanks to remember, Ren.
Great. So, yeah, this is the simulation, the first one, right? We are working on the next two. So, guys, any more questions here, Felipe?
No, just comments on the video. Everybody's saying it was great, nostalgic. I think it showed the age of some of us. But that's okay. If anybody has further questions, I think we can collect yeah. them over the communication channels.
Okay, so here, guys, this is our email, okay? You can, I will send more information for everybody, but if you need, send to Hyatt Skoods or in skoods.org, we also have the form there for contact and so on. But tomorrow we'll send more info. All good?
Okay, and see you in Mars.
Sorry?
See you in Mars. See
you. In Mars.
In Mars.
Okay.
Let's go to Mars.
Why not? Mars. We can make a race there.
Yeah. For sure. We already have the terrain.
We go for Moon first, then we go to Mars.
Oh, okay. Yeah. From Moon, the first step.
It is top flight.
Hey guys, so thank you very much for this. I hope
thank
to see
you.
A few of you in the next meeting next week, which is the first meeting for the race, guys. So who is racing must be there. Okay.
Thanks, Fernando. Fantastic. Thanks, Guy, for
thanks,
the support.
Thank you, everybody. Bye bye.
Thanks,
guys. Fernando, I guess I'll speak to you after this meeting. So if you can contact me.
Yeah, sure. Sure.
Good job. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Cool.
Thanks, guys. Bye.
Cheers, guys. Bye. Fernando, se você ficar aí...